A warm welcome to this evening's Cronies Gala Ladies' Night. Well, a virtual Ladies' Night. It's such a privilege to be able to present to you a superb lineup of artists. We'll be heading over to Florence and to Julia, who will introduce us to two very special opera singers. Here in Scotland, I wanted to invite as many freelance musicians as the budget would allow. It's been, and will continue to be, an extremely difficult time for artists. The Scottish mezzo-soprano Cheryl Forbes and her husband Gordon Cree have been Cronies favourites for many years now. They share with us their fabulous and varied talents. Also, we've got the exciting and innovative Gaia duo of violinist Katrina Lee and cellist Alice Allen. Clarinetist Jean Johnson will be joined by her husband and one of the UK's top solo concert pianists, Stephen Osborne. And as well as all that, Scottish baritone Andy McTaggart was able to join us here at Glasgow Cathedral for a song or two with Andrew Forbes at the piano. But it's time to hear from our Julia, the Cronies Philharmonic, who has her own very warm welcome to offer you.
Gentlemen of the Cronies, how lovely to, well, not see you again, because I can't see you, unfortunately. Hope you enjoyed the concert we gave for you at Christmas time. And it's great that you wanted to have another one. This time only with two singers, Ángel Vargas, our amazing tenor, and our very own Lauren Young from Stirling. They've got an amazing programme of operatic greats for you, including the mighty duets from Trovatore. It's not very often that you get to hear those, because you don't often get two singers who can sing it, singing in the same concert. So I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. And I just want to say thank you so much for asking for these concerts. It's such an important and difficult time for everybody, especially musicians. Work's been cancelled. Nobody quite knows what's going to happen in the future. So to have moments of joy where we can bring music to you is so very important. And I want to thank you. And I really hope that you enjoy the concert.
Thank you, Julia. Looking fabulous as always, and looking every bit at home in that 15th century Italian palazzo. And you can imagine if Julia were able to model for Michelangelo in Florence just now, he'd certainly have his hands full. Well, as she said, we're very fortunate to have both Ángel and Lauren singing for us, and here they are to introduce their own opening selection for us.
Good evening, gentlemen of you Cronies. We are so pleased to be performing for you tonight a little selection of our greatest hits that we have been learning about here in Florence with amazing Julia. Our first section tonight is our French music section, particularly focusing on Werther. We start this section with Valle si coule mi l'amo. Charlotte has been reading the letters that Werther has sent her, and it's caused her to be unable to hold back her tears. When her sister comes in and annoyingly says, "What's wrong and why are your eyes red?" She replies by saying, "Sometimes it's good to cry about your deepest, darkest feelings, to just let it all out. Otherwise, your heart will become too big and just break."
Then we go on to Pourquoi me réveiller, where Werther is madly in love with Charlotte and he hasn't seen her in exactly 1 year. He returns to the house. She's married to another man, and he basically just sent the "I miss you" text when you know your ex has already gotten another, a new boyfriend, a new husband, and he says, "I miss you." And that stirs up a lot of emotions in Charlotte. And he's very, very manipulative and takes advantage of this because he knows that Charlotte loves him and not the other man. At the end, she leaves and he's left in desperation.
Thank you.
The duet from Massenet's opera Werther, ending that French opera section from Angèle and Lauren with Julia at the piano. More from them when it will be an Italian selection. Well, our first instrumentalists of the evening are currently ensemble in residence at Chamber Music Scotland, an organisation that helps coordinate and organise the music club scene here in Scotland. It's a vital lifeline for musicians in this country. Katrina Lee and Alice Allen, before lockdown happened, they were very, very busy freelancers who worked with all the major professional orchestras in Scotland. But they also worked in a variety of music genres like Celtic Connections. The Gaia duo appeared in Classics Unwrapped when they formed, and they've been very busy creating lots of online activity during lockdown. But I'll let them do the introductions.
Hello, I'm Katrina Lee. I'm one half of the Gaia duo. I play the violin alongside Alice Allen on the cello. We're really excited tonight to be able to share some music with you, even if it is remotely, but we're really happy to be able to still play some of our favourite pieces and share with you some of the tunes that we've been researching and exploring over the past 2 years. Alice is going to be telling you a little bit more about that, but for now we just wanted to wish you a very happy evening of music and hopefully we'll get to play for you live soon.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for having us along to play this evening. We are really delighted to be here and would like to say a big thank you to Jamie McDougall for having us along. Tonight we're going to play a few different things for you that range in styles and genre. We're going to begin by playing a lovely folk traditional tune called Inishir. I've also heard it called Inisor. And Inishir is a small island just off the coast, the west coast of Ireland. We've never been, but we would love to go one day because this tune is very evocative. We arranged it together and it reminds me of playing together actually when we were able to before the pandemic. So we hope you enjoy this. Then we're going to go on and play for you Grotesque by Rebecca Clark. This is a piece that's the second half of a pair of pieces that come together. The first part is called Lullaby, which we're not playing tonight, but that's also very beautiful and worth listening to. Really recommend it. Grotesque, I think the definition is comically or repulsively distorted. So we do our very best to do that for you in this performance. Thank you.
Thank you to Katrina and Alice, the Gaia duo. More from them later. For now, it's time to welcome to our ladies' night the wonderful clarinetist Jean Johnson and her husband, the internationally acclaimed pianist Stephen Osborne. It's Stephen's 50th birthday this year, and the Wigmore Hall in London marked it by inviting him to give a very special concert. In fact, Jean went and played with him too. Well, when they were recording this, Stephen tweeted that it'd been 3 months since he needed to wear his concert shoes and he'd forgotten just how uncomfortable they were, something I'm sure some of you ladies can sympathise with. Well, Jean and Stephen filmed their piece in their own wee bubble at home in Edinburgh, and they'll play three pieces for us as the evening unfolds. But I'm going to let Jean introduce their first work.
Hello and welcome to our living room. I'm Jean and this is Stephen. We've prepared for you three short encore-style pieces. If you've ever had just dessert for dinner, that's a little bit of what you're going to get just now. So the first piece we're going to play is a piece by French composer Gabriel Pierney called Canzonetta. It was written in 1888. Pierney was mostly known for being a conductor and also an organist. He studied at the Paris Conservatoire with Massenet and César Franck, and he's most noteworthy for having conducted the premiere in 1910 of Stravinsky's The Firebird. But this piece has endured in the clarinet repertoire. We hope you enjoy Canzonetta. Thank you.
Gene Johnson and Stephen Osborne there with a terrific opener. More from them shortly. Last October, I had planned to invite Andrew McTaggart to open the season. It would have been part of his debut CD launch tour that would have seen him perform at the RCS, at St Andrew's Voices Festival, and more besides. That didn't happen, but will when it's safe to do so. In the meantime, I thought it would be an opportunity lost not to have him with us tonight. So to tell us more about the CD and what he's going to sing for us, I was very keen to ask him what the CD was all about. Andy McTaggart, thanks for joining us for our Ladies' Night for Cronies.
You're very welcome.
Tell us about this wonderful CD, your debut CD.
Absolutely. It's the first CD, and it came around through a kind of unexpected moment when I was down singing with Tim Dean. Now, he used to be my head of opera at the Alexander Gibson Opera School. He's since then retired to Cornwall, to Penzance. And while I was down there getting ready to perform a recital for a festival which he works with, we were going through Finzi's Earth and Air and Rain, and he was saying, "This really suits you." And I was really enjoying it, and he was enjoying it. And he just said, "Why don't we record it at some point?" And then later on that summer, I went down, we recorded it. We then went for a little bit more recording in October, and that was 2 years ago now. Time flies.
Of course, the plans were that you were going to be launching it in the autumn of last year in 2020. We actually talked about having you come and be the opening concert in October as part of the big launch of this debut CD. All that, of course, went to the wayside. But we look forward that when it's safe to do so, that you'll properly launch your CD and you'll have a recital to it, and that you'll come to the Cronies and sing for us. Will you do that?
Absolutely, I'd love to.
So it's an all English song CD. What are you going to sing for us tonight?
Well, the main work within the CD is Earth and Air and Rain by Finzi, poems by Thomas Hardy. So I'm going to sing number 6 from the cycle. It's called Rollicum Rorum. And this is basically saying that pigs will fly before Napoleon gets to invade London.
Sacre bleu. Enjoy.
Lawyers strive to heal a breach and parsons practice what they preach. When Bonnie Hill comes bouncing down and marches men on London town. Rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay, rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay. Justice is on equal scales, and rogues are only found in jails. Then Bonnie Hill comes bouncing down and marches men on London town. Rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay, rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay. When rich men find their wealth a curse and fill he with a poor man's purse, then Bonnie Hill come bouncing down and march his men on London town. Rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay, rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay. Husbands with their wives agree, and maids were made from modesty. Then Bonnie Hill come bouncing down and march his men on London town. Rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay, rollicum rorum tollalorum, rollicum rorum tollalay.
Rollicking Rome indeed. Well, more from Andy later when he joins me for a well-known duet by Offenbach. For now, it's back to Florence, where Angel and Lauren tell us what delights await us in their Italian opera selection.
Gentlemen, now we're going to talk about the Italian section of our program. We start with La Donna Mobile from Rigoletto. And the Duke, I don't think the ladies will feel the same way, but is one of the greatest, most sly men in opera. And he basically is singing, telling us about how women are changeable like a car and a motorcycle, and how you can go from one to another without having any consequences.
Talking about bad guys in opera, La Gioconda, my character Laura finds herself in a very bad situation. She has a rival in love. This particular woman is on the boat, preparing herself to stab Laura because she wants her man. However, when she hears me saying my fervent prayer to the Madonna to look after me and make sure everything will be okay, she changes her mind and it works. We then have two duets from Il Trovatore by Verdi. I, as Lucena, have had a pretty bad start in life, and if I was to go and to explain the full plot of Il Trovatore, I would be here all night and you'd have no singing. So, in short, I threw a baby into the fire that was mine. I've not told him that he's not my baby, but he thinks that I'm his mum. I want him to avenge my mother by killing his brother. However, he tells me that when he had the opportunity, he heard a call from heaven saying, don't do it. I'm incensed. I can't believe that he's done this. He's foiled my plan. However, then when he decides to tell me that the messengers told him that his girlfriend actually is still in love with him and not his evil brother, I again become absolutely raging. Why you want to go? You need to stay with me so that I can have my plan play out exactly the way I want it to go.
Thank you. Oh,
great to hear voices like that singing this repertoire, all that passion. Of course, that's how people used to express their feelings. And nowadays, it would all be said on WhatsApp. Well, from Florence in Italy to Darvel in Ayrshire, and two very special musicians and artists who just happen to be very good friends of mine and yours, Cheryl Forbes and Gordon Cree. Cheryl Forbes is one of the most beautiful voices that I know and I've had the pleasure of working with. We'll hear her shortly singing Gershwin's Someone to Watch Over Me. Before that, here's her husband Gordon playing one of the smorgasbord of musical instruments that he's master of, playing Jovial Jasper on xylophone. It's Gordon Cree.
For this lost land.
a Gershwin classic, Someone to Watch Over Me, sung by Cheryl Forbes and accompanied by Gordon Cree. Well, staying with Gershwin, it's back to that rather lovely New Town Music Room in Edinburgh for Gene Johnson and Stephen Osborne with another number from Gershwin. Here's Gene to explain.
The next number we're going to play for you is called Walking the Dog, and it's one of the many musical numbers written in 1937 by George Gershwin for the Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers film score for Shall We Dance? In the film, the music accompanies a sequence of walking a dog on board of a luxury cruise liner. In 1960, this sequence was published as Promenade. In black and white film, you can imagine Ginger Rogers seen going to and fro with her little terrier. Fred Astaire notices her and would really like to talk to her. He spots a gentleman from the ship's crew who is also holding a dog. So he offers a little bit of money to him for the favor of borrowing his dog so that he can also walk around to and fro with the dog, maybe catching up with Ginger. She is thoroughly unamused by him, but the music is extremely catchy and very amusing indeed. We hope you think so too. Promenade.
Gershwin's Walking the Dog, something many of us have been doing during lockdown. It was the only thing that some of us could actually do. And I heard people were actually renting dogs out so folk could have an excuse to leave the house again. Well, another American standard now from Cheryl Forbes, Roger and Hart's Spring is Here. And with the vaccine rollout going so well, we might actually be able to enjoy spring this year.
Sat at little tables and drank May wine. Now
Safe to say, Gordon Cree wasn't bumbling about there. I love the fact that he's able to smile at the camera and not look down at the sticks. That is a sign of a true pro. Well, it's time to head back to Florence, where Lauren and Angelo introduce us to their Spanish programme. Olé.
Gentlemen, once again, now we're going to talk about the Spanish section of our programme, and we're going to start off with the genre of zarzuela. In La Zarzuela, the Tabernera del Puerto, my character, Rodolfo, he's in a pub, in a tavern, drinking with his buddies, when suddenly he is pissed at a big, big level because one of his friends has just told him that the girl that he likes is actually playing with him, and she's not a sweet girl. She's been a bit of a naughty girl. So Rodolfo then sings on this very manly, passionate, angry, I don't believe this, what you have told me right now. And he basically screams his heart out and has a beer. Sounds like a good night to me.
And then for something completely different, two songs from Shibi Monsalvace's Cinco Canciones Negras, the first of one being A Lullaby to a Tiny Child. It's a very sweet song that tells the child that there is hope. These are based in South America,
Cuba.
Angel knows a lot about this, and he told me a very interesting fact. And the woman, we suspect, has bore child from her slave owner. The last song of the set, Canto Negro, a really rousing pub tune. That seems to be the theme of the Spanish section. And it speaks of a man who's so drunk that he can't stop singing and dancing to the point where he falls down drunk in front of everyone there. But Angel did tell me a really interesting fact that it is a Cuban dance.
It is. So you're going to find, you're going to hear it. It's a very percussive song. And you hear the piano answer what Lauren is singing. For example, it goes, yambambo, yambambo, ay. And this in the dance, la bomba, is a woman has a skirt and she goes, yambambo, yambambo, ay. And then the drum is supposed to answer, pa pa pa, ay. So it's actually a really nice dance.
Yes.
No puede ser, esa mujer es buena. No puede ser.
Ciao, Italy, and halloreir to Scotland. Back to Edinburgh for another clarinet piece from the wonderful Gene Johnson and Stephen Osborne.
Our final number for you is a short showpiece composed by the team of Faustin and Maurice Jean-Jean, who were relatively minor French composers, but as a team, they have had a few enduring compositions nevertheless. This piece is dedicated to their friend Henri Guigan, hence the title Guiganterie. Originally for clarinet and orchestra, it was probably written about 1950. Guiganterie.
Staying in Scotland, it's another selection from the Gaia Duo, this time of old Scottish tunes with a great story. And to tell us that story, here's Alice Allen.
Finally, we're going to finish with a set of historical Scottish tunes. And they were written in the golden age of fiddle music, sort of 1780 to 1840-ish. But rather than being written by Nathaniel Gow or Neil Gower or all the people we'd expect to hear, William Marshall, they're actually written by ladies, which is really unusual. Most of our historical Scottish tune repertoire, it kind of excluding songs, I would say, is written by males. So Cree and I were really interested to know if ladies were writing, and in fact they were, and they wrote quite a lot. And some ladies who came from more wealthy backgrounds managed to get some of their tunes published. Very often they were published anonymously with just the first letter of their name, and then the rest was scored out. Sometimes you could kind of make a good guess about who they were because they might write a tune for their husband and name the tune after them. So tonight we're going to play for you Lady Lucy Ramsay's favourite Strathspey, and followed by A Lovely Reel. And we're also going to play Lady Maria Parker's Strathspey, and also followed that with a reel. So we're playing these exactly as they were penned by the composers. I'm playing the original bass lines along with the tune. And during the golden age of fiddle music, cello and violin was the most popular sort of combination, especially for dance band music. So you're kind of hearing it in its really raw original form, and very often we don't think of the cello actually now as a as a traditional instrument in Scottish music, but it really was. It was the mainstay of dance band, and it was kind of superseded by the piano and the accordion and guitar when those instruments became more readily available and people could have them in their homes. So this feels like a really historical sound, which we both absolutely love, and we hope you enjoy it too.
Last year, we lost a real showbiz legend, Dame Vera Lynn. Her songs kept a nation going during the hardest and darkest of times. And although she hadn't been called upon to lead the troops in a sing-along for some time, she was still very much the force's sweetheart. Well, we couldn't let her passing go unnoticed, so here is Crony's sweetheart to lead our tribute to Dame Vera Lynn.
Happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing the
Thank you, Cheryl, for that glorious sing-along opportunity for the cronies in that Vera Lynn tribute. And in the words of that great Vera Lynn song, let's hope we all get to meet again very soon indeed. And what a party that's going to be. And Gordon Wilson, you're buying. Well, it's encore time now. And one last visit to Italy with Julia, Lauren and Angel. Dina would have loved that, I'm sure. Volare, sung for us by Lauren and Angel in Florence, and at the piano, well, the one and only Julia Lynch, the Cronies Philharmonic. Well, it's time to quickly welcome back baritone Andy McTaggart for a wee encore duet with yours truly. It's not been performed at the Cronies for a number of years now, so it's due an airing. This is Offenbach's Gendarme Duet.
Guardians bold yet wary,
men of us all three take good care
to risk a precious life's we're chary.
When danger looms, we're never there.
But when we meet a helpless woman
or little boys that do no harm,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we shall them bear the bold gendarme.
We run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we shall them bear the bold gendarme.
Sometimes and the duties extra more.
The little butterflies we chase.
We like to gamble in things rural.
Commune with nature face to face.
But to a beat, then back return.
Refreshed by nature's holy charm.
We run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we serve them here, the bold gendarme.
We run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we serve them here, the bold gendarme.
If gentlemen will make a riot,
and pinches are the late at night,
we're quite disposed to keep it quiet,
provided that they make it right.
But if they do not seem to see it,
or give to us the proper terms,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we shall them bear the bold gendarme.
We run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in,
we run them in, we shall them bear.
Well, that's almost it for our Cronies Gala evening. I hope you've enjoyed the music and the wide range of repertoire superbly played and sung by an incredible lineup of artists. Being able to have so many wonderful artists on the same bill has been amazing. And I hope that their playing and their messages have touched you all. Now, I'm sure like me, you can't wait for the pandemic to be over for lots of reasons, but for the chance to be together in each other's company again and to enjoy live music will be a truly uplifting moment. I have one more song for you, and it's a song that was used by the St Andrew's Voices Festival as a message of hope for us all. Using footage from a performance of Lauder, they streamed me singing Harry Lauder's Keep Right On to the End of the Road. Now, last year, the Cronies as a body and as individuals contributed so much to the crowdfunder set up to film Lauder for the big 150th celebration. And the message that this song conveys continues to provide encouragement, strength, and hope for us all at this time. I sincerely hope to see you next season at Cronies, but for now, I'll leave you to sing along with me in Lauder's Keep Right On to the End of the Road.
Every road through life is a long, long road filled with joy and sorrow too. As you journey on, how your heart will yearn for the things most dear to you. With wealth and love it is so, but onward we must go. Keep right on to the end of the road. Keep right on to the end. Though the way be long, let your heart beat strong. Keep right on round the bend. Though you're tired and weary, still journey on till you come to your happy abode. When all your love you've been dreaming of will be there at the end of the road. With a big stout heart to a long steep hill, we will get there with a smile. With a good kind thought and the end in view, we will cut short many a mile. So let courage every day be your guiding star always. Keep right on to the end of the road. Keep right on to the end. Though the way be long, let your heart beat strong. Keep right on around the bend.